Hello everyone, my name is Noy Matiaras. I'm DGT Social Science at Kendra Vidyalaya Imphal number 2. Today I'm going to teach a topic from the class 8 civic chapter number 1, and the name of the chapter is the Indian Constitution. So let's start the chapter. So we are going to start from the introduction. Okay, introduction about the Constitution. And here we have the picture of the Constitution. This is a picture of Constitution, Indian Constitution of India. It is taken from the NCERT book, and we have 2 points in the introduction. So let's start from the first one. A society also has a constitute rule that make it what it is and differentiate it from other kind of societies. In a large societies in which different communities of the people live together, these rules of the rules are formulated through consensus, and in modern countries this consensus is usually available in the written form. Okay, so in every society different people are going to live, and these different people, they're going to share some set of rule. They're going to make a rule to live together. But in a model country, what happened is that they written down that rule. Okay, so that written document of the rule we're going to call as what? Constitution. That is in the second point here. A written document in which we find such rule is called a constitution. Okay, a written document where that set of the rule that agreed by the age that everyone of this everyone living in that society or in that country. Okay, that we going to be called as the constitution. Now let's come to the next topic, and the name of the topic is importance of constitution. That means why we need constitution. The first one, that is, the constitution serves several purposes. First point is, it lay out a certain ideal that form the basis of the kind of the country that we as citizens inspire to live in. Put another way, a constitution tells us what the fundamental nature of our society is. So the constitution going to tell us that what kind of society we are living. Okay, or what kind of the country is, whether that country is a secular country or not a secular country, whether that country give us the freedom of expression, freedom of the press, okay, or that this country is a republic country or not. So all this thing is been this nature of the country, or of we can call as a fundamental nature of our society, we will be fine, or it will be best on the basis of the what? Constitution. Then the next one, okay, next, that is importance of constitution. In the second point of importance of constitution, a constitution helps serve as a share of the rule and principle that all person in a country can agree upon as the basis of the way in which they want the country to be governed. So in a constitution, okay, what we can find is that what type of the government is going to be ruled in that country, or in the constitution itself we will come to know that how the this representative elected, whether is representative are elected by people or not, whether it is a selected person or elected person. Okay, it's going to be known from the what? It's going to be known from the constitution. So here is a one picture of the Nepal. Okay, the people of the Nepal, they are protesting in the 2005, and they are demanding that we should have the constitution and we should have the what? Democratic form of the government. So yeah, it is also be taken from the NCERT book. Okay, so in the constitution we can know that from the constitution we can know that what type of the government going to be ruled in that country. Okay, this is the second importance of the constitution. Now let's come to the third one. From the third one, another important purpose of the constitution is that is to define the nature of the country political system. So the constitution going to define the nature of the political system. Like suppose in India we have the constitution. Here we have the constitution. Okay, then the power going to be divided equally to the legislature, executive and the judiciary. Then we simply we call as the horizontal distribution of the power. Okay, these three going to have the equal power. Okay. Then in the legislature it's going to include the president, then the parliament. In the parliament we have the Rajya Sabha, then the Lok Sabha. Then in the executive, we are going to have the prime minister and the council of the minister. Okay. But in the judiciary, we have the Supreme Court, High Court, okay, and the district court. So these three, the upper three, this one, okay, let me circle it. These three, they're going to have the equal power and they're going to check each other. Okay, this type, this nature of the political system is going to be defined in the constitution. This is the third important of constitution. The fourth importance of our constitution is the constitution lay down rule that guard against the misuse of authority by our political leader. It means that the constitution laid down as some safeguard from the safeguard against the misuse of power. Okay, so regarding this, there is a one story in your NCERT book, and the story that I have pasted here, the story is just actually the story is about the one boy who is a monitor of the class, and he misused his power. When the teacher say that you have to mind the class, what he do is that he intentionally write the name of the student who did not make noise, but who are not agreed by the his ideology, okay, or his idea, who are always be against with him. So he intentionally write the name of the dead student and give the name to the teacher, and the teacher punished to the dead student. Here the monitor is misusing his power. Okay, so there is a one story in the NCERT book. So think about that, if our political leader, okay, started to misuse the misuse their power, then what going to happen in our society? Okay, so the constitution laid out some safeguard, okay, against this misuse of power. Next, fifth point about the importance of constitution. Another important function that a constitution play in the democracy is to ensure that a dominant group does not use its power against other less powerful people or group. Okay, so another important of the constitution is that it not going to allow the powerful group to dominate over the less powerful group. Okay, here is a one story in the NCERT book, that is suppose during the game time, okay, game time of a one particular class, and in that class there are 30 boys and 20 girls, and in the same playground the boys want to play cricket and the girls want to play the volleyball. But what the teacher is saying that let's take a boat. Of course, the now during the boat, what going to happen, the boys, the strength of the boys is 30 and the strength of girls is 20, so boys definitely going to win. So every time boys play cricket and girls did not get what opportunity to play their volleyball. So here what happening is that the teacher are not considering about the girls because their number is less. But in the society, if this such thing happen, then it's going to create a problem. That's why the constitution plays some kind of the important role, that the majority group or the powerful group did not dominate the less powerful group or a minority group. Okay, this is the fifth point. Now let's come to the next one. There is a sixth point. Constitution is precisely to prevent this tyranny or the domination by the majority of the majority of a minority. This can be refers to a one community dominating another, that is the inter-community domination, or a member of the one community dominating other within the same community, that is the intra-community domination. Here that point is that the constitution going to safeguard or going to prevent the domination of the that high caste to the low caste, or maybe a majority community to the minority community. Okay, if it is one community dominating the another community, that we call as the inter-community domination. And within the community, okay, if within the community, suppose the high within this Hindu community, high caste is dominating the low caste group, high caste group dominating the low caste, that we call as the intra-community domination. Okay, so constitution going to be work out, okay, to prevent such kind of the domination. Here is a picture of the inter-community domination, this one. Okay, here what happening is the white community, this person belongs to the white community, okay, and the people of the black community, they are walking here in the field. Okay, So what happened here is that white community is dominating over the black community. So it is a one picture related with it is inter-community domination. Next one. The last one, this one is a 6 point, that is another significant reason why we need a constitution is to save us from ourselves. Okay, this part is important, to save us from ourselves. Now what is the meaning of to save us from ourselves is that the constitution going to be give us some freedom or some right, like political right, right to vote, civil rights, social right, okay, and economic right to the society. But if the leader, okay, if the leader want to take over that is right from you, then that time the constitution going to prevent you, okay, it's going to protect you, okay, they're going to protect you, the constitution going to protect you that this right should be not taken from the people, okay. Say in a democratic country this right are given to the citizen, but in a dictatorship, okay, this right are been taken from the people. This right are not given to the people, common people. Okay, that means if the constitution is there, okay, that constitution going to provide you the such right, and it going to protect you, okay, from the some leader who want to take that right from you. So this why we need the constitution. There are 6 points given in this video. Okay, then now let's come. Here I think we finished the first part. Now let's come to the homework. We have two questions. First one, why do a democratic country needs a constitution? So I've given you 6 points. Out of that 6 points, write any 5 points. Okay, you have to write 5 points. Okay, let me write 5 here. You have to write 5 points. Then the next one. Write down the name of the Indian states which share border with the following neighboring country, a neighboring nation, that is Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal. So you have to write the name of the state who share a border with the Bangladesh. Okay, I think you have to write that West Bengal, Assam, then the Meghalaya, Tripura. Okay, like that Bhutan you have to write the there is Sikkim, then Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, okay, Nepal, they have to write that which state share a border with Nepal. Okay, so you have to write the name of the state. So here we finish the part one. Thank you everyone.